இங்கே हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नारायण ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। केमिस्ट्री असाइनमेंट डे 14, 8th क्लास, टॉपिक केमिकल बॉन्डिंग, सब टॉपिक हाइब्रिडाइजेशन। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, फाइंड द हाइब्रिडाइजेशन ऑफ SF6 मॉलिक्यूल बाय यूजिंग द टोटल मॉलिक्यूलर बैलेंसिंग मेथड। सपोज सी हियर, इन दिस मेथड सिंपली फर्स्ट यू राइट द टोटल वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन ए मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ टोटल एटम्स। देन इफ द टोटल वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स greater than 8, then we will divide that with 8. Then whatever the quotient we are getting, that is equal to total number of hybrid orbitals. That indicates the particular hybridization. If less than 8, that indicates the direct hybrid orbitals. So see here, SF6. So here sulfur, valence electrons 6. Next, fluorine, valence electrons 7. Total how many fluorine atoms there? 6 there. Now see here, total valence electrons 48. That means here sulfur belongs to the 60A group or 60th group. 6 valence electrons. Fluorine belongs to the 70A group. So total 7 valence electrons. So 7 into 6, 42. Total valence electron 48. Then in the step 2, we will divide the 48 with 8. Then what will get? 6. Here 6 is the quotient. 6 is the quotient. This indicates the hybrid orbitals. Hybrid orbitals. So the 6 hybrid orbitals possible only in the sp3d2 hybridization. In the sp hybridization, only 2 hybrid orbitals. sp2 hybridization, 2 hybrid orbitals. sp3, 4 hybrid orbitals. sp3d, 5 hybrid orbitals. sp3d2, 6 hybrid orbitals. sp3d3, 7 hybrid orbitals. Next question, find the hybridization of HCO3 molecule by using the total molecular valency method. Now coming to here, our molecule is HCO3. In case of the xenon, the number of valence electrons 8. Total how many valence electrons we have? 8. Next, in case of the oxygen, number of valence electrons 6 into 3 atoms. Total here we get 18. So 18 plus 8. So total valence electrons we are getting 26, which is greater than 8. Then divide that number with 8. So in the step 2, okay, now 26 by 8, then what will get here? See here, quotient we are getting 3, and the remainder we are getting 2. Then keep the quotient by side, and if you get the remainder, if you get any remainder, then divide the remainder with 2. Then what we are getting here? 1. Then see here, total hybrid orbitals is equal to total quotient. Here what we are getting? 3. Here what we are getting quotient? 1. So 3 plus 1. We are getting the total hybrid orbitals 4. That is possible in the case of the sp3 hybridization. Next, find the number of hybrid orbitals in the H2S molecule. Now see here, H2S molecule, sulfur, number of valence electrons 6, each hydrogen atom, number of valence electrons 1, 2 hydrogen atoms, so 1 into 2. So here total valence electrons 8. If you are getting the total valence electrons 8 or less than 8, then divide the total valence electrons with 2. Greater than 8, divide with them with 8. That is the rule. Next, step 2. Total valence electrons 8. Then we have to divide with 2. So here 4. Here 4 indicates the number of hybrid orbitals. Here 4 is the pore shell. So if you are getting the pore shell 4, then it gets the number of hybrid orbitals. Last question, find the number of hybrid orbitals in PCl5 molecules. So you have the two options, molecular orbitals method, next one, direct valency method. Now see here we can find number of hybrid orbitals. P equal half into number of valence electrons on central atom plus monovalent atoms. So here half into valence electrons on the central atom plus monovalent atoms. So here how many valence electrons? 5. How many monovalent atoms? 5. So what we get here? 10/2. Then we get 5. So your 5 indicates the 5 hybrid orbitals. So the hybridization will be sp3d hybridization.